absolutely aesthetic physique, if anything. In my humble opinion, a lot of guys, they don't realize if it's the first video they see of me, they think I'm some sort of narcissist, but nothing could be further from the truth. I am very humble, amazing as it is, but yeah, I am. It's true. Anyway, enough about my great levels of juiciness and humility. I thought to chime in to the mewing topic because I saw that the New York Times magazine had written a piece on Dr. John Mew and Dr. Mike Mew, and they mentioned yours truly as well, so I will read you the passage. Mike especially appreciated the words of Marcus Follin, a Swedish bodybuilder and ethno-nationalist vlogger who calls himself the Golden One. In a popular video, the Golden One explained to his 100,000 subscribers how mewing could help return vigor and good looks to modern men. After the British Orthodontic Society expelled Mike, the Golden One rallied his followers to spread mewing videos in order to combat Mike's orthodontic adversaries, who he said had a vested interest in silencing the mews. Yes, I am proud to have aided with that support. I do believe John and Mike are heroes because they are taking heat, they are taking risks for the greater good of humanity. Much like myself. And for me, that is a heroic thing to do. And I do believe that humanity as a whole would be better off if everyone knew about their teachings. Now, if we're talking about wisdom teeth, jaw development, crooked teeth, airways, etc., I want to present the teachings of the Muse in context with some other books, which I will now talk a bit about. So first and foremost, personal hero of mine, Weston Price, wrote this fine book where he went around the world, looked at Aboriginal populations and compared them when they ate their traditional diet and compared it to when they started eating a modern diet, and he saw just the teeth health and the overall health just plummeted downwards once they got access to sugar and white flour, etc. So this is a book mandatory reading for all parents. I have been hugely influenced by this book. Of course, mention it in my own book as well. Shameless plug. It's okay because it's me and you expect me to do that sort of thing. Anyway, another book also that I recommend. I've talked about this before. I have made book reviews on Weston Price and this book as well. So The Oxygen Advantage by Patrick McKeown. He talks a lot about mouth breathing, and mouth breathing is also related to, you know, the diet and also a correct tongue posture. So that is a book I wholeheartedly recommend as well. Then I am almost done with this fine tome of knowledge, The Dental Diet by Dr. Stephen Lin. I actually follow Dr. Stephen Lin on Instagram. He's a great guy. He has a lot of good takes, a lot of good insights into not only teeth, but overall health. You know, on this channel, we have a holistic view of things, which means that, you know, if you have good teeth or if you have bad teeth, it's also a symptom of something deeper. And that's exactly how Dr. Stephen Lin approaches it as well. I'm almost done with it. I will make a book review later on, but from what I've read so far, I can definitely recommend it as well. So if you put mewing into the context of eating and breathing, and of course correct tongue posture, etc., it makes perfect sense. So I'm not saying that, oh, you will get a super nice jaw just because you start mewing, just because you start having a correct tongue posture, but I do say that in children, at least, if you have a correct diet when you're young, when you're a child, if you breathe correctly through your nose, and if you have a correct tongue posture, then your jaw might develop properly. And if you think about it, how unnatural, isn't it, to have to remove your wisdom teeth? For the record, I have all of my wisdom teeth still intact. I haven't removed any. That is why I'm so wise. I'm sorry, I couldn't resist. But anyway, if you think about it, evolutionary speaking, it doesn't make any sense at all to have to remove them. But, you know, nowadays it's almost like a natural thing. Oh, your wisdom teeth are coming out, you have to remove them. But if we look, yeah, again, evolutionary speaking, it makes more sense that the jaw should be able to accommodate for all of them. But the teachings at hand, correct tongue posture, etc. Super important for children, just as a proper diet is super important for children. So if you understand all of these sort of things in a basket of holy knowledge, so you have mewing, you have the dental diet, the teachings of Weston Price, correct breathing patterns, etc., then it starts to make sense. So keep that in mind if you talk about mewing to someone. It's not only, oh, you will get a great jaw at an adult age just because you start having different resting tongue posture, but everything combined in a young age will definitely make a difference. So anyway, I again show my support for the Muse, and I will link Mike's YouTube channel below so you can see what is up, because he can of course explain his own concept better than I can. But yeah, that said, do check out the other books I recommended as well, and you will not regret yourself. So anyway, thank you for watching. And thank you to New York Times for keeping the article relatively objective and neutral. Not every day you see that from mainstream media. XOXO, boom.